Hello students, today we are going to start chapter 4 heat. Okay, our next chapter is heat. In this chapter we are going to learn about heat, temperature, different scales of measuring the temperature, thermometer, different types of thermometers like clinical thermometer, laboratory thermometer. Okay, and how the transfer of heat takes place, like through conduction, convection, radiation. These are the topics we are going to deal with the chapter 4, heat. Now, the question arises, what is heat? Suppose if I ask you a question, in winters, what kind of clothes do we wear? So, you people know the answer that we wear woolen clothes. Why we wear woolen clothes in winter? We wear woolen clothes in winter because they keep us warm. They don't allow our heat from our body to go out, or from the outer from the atmosphere, the cold waves get inside. These woolen clothes prevent the cold waves. They don't allow it to enter into our body. Why? Because these winter clothes keeps us warm. Suppose if I tell you in winters, you would like to stay in the sun or in the room? Yeah, it's that you would like to stay in the sun. Why? Because the heat is produced by the sun, and in that heat you feel warm. Now, what is heat? Heat is a form of energy. We know that heat is an energy which makes us feel the sensation of coldness and hotness. So, what is heat? Heat is a form of energy that makes us feel the sensation of coldness and hotness of our body. Next, what are hot and cold bodies? So, if we in everyday life come under, some objects are hot and some objects are cold. How can you feel the hot object or a cold object? Through one of our sense organs. We have 5 sense organs: eyes, ears, nose, skin and tongue. Through the skin, we can sense the heat radiation. If I tell you to go and stand outside in the sun, how you will say that, ma'am, the sun, I am feeling hot? Because the heat radiations of the sun is striking your body, which helps you to detect that the sun is providing the heat. So sense of touch works here, but sometimes the sense of touch does not give you the correct response. For example, we can go with one activity. Take 3 beakers containing the water. The beaker A containing hot water, beaker B normal water, and beaker C cold water, chilled cold water. Now, in the beaker A, take the right finger of your hand and dip it into that. What do you feel? We feel that when you dip the finger, we feel that it is hot. Take the left hand finger and dip it in the cold water. What does you feel? We feel that it's cold. Now, take both the fingers after keeping it in both the beakers after 1 minute. Both the fingers now take out and put it into the beaker B. Can you feel? At this time, the sensation of touch does not work. So, what we do to measure the hotness and coldness of a body? First, we'll define what is temperature. Temperature is the degree of measuring the hotness and coldness of an object. Whether your body is hot or cold, that is temperature. This temperature can be measured with the help of a device called as thermometer. Okay, and this thermometer thermometer is an instrument to measure the temperature. Okay, we have different scales of different scales to measure the temperature. Like if I ask you how water is measured, you will say milliliters. If I ask you how length is measured, you will say centimeters, meters or kilometers. Similarly, temperature is also measured in 3 different scales: Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin. In your syllabus, we have only 2 scales, Celsius scale and Fahrenheit scale. Okay, we measure the temperature with three different scales, Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale and Kelvin scale. But in your syllabus only we have two scales, Celsius scale and Fahrenheit scale. Celsius scale, it is denoted by degree C. And Fahrenheit is denoted by degree F. We have two fixed point in the Celsius Kelvin scales. If I ask you a question, at what temperature does the ice form? You will say that it's 0 degrees centigrade. So that is the lower fixed point of Celsius scale, 0 degrees. At 0 degrees, water changes into ice. Similarly, at 100 degrees, this is the upper fixed point where the water changes into the steam. So upper fixed point of the Celsius scale is 100 degrees. Similarly, Fahrenheit, it is denoted by degree Fahrenheit. The lower fixed point of the Fahrenheit is 32 degree Fahrenheit. And the upper fixed point is 212 degree Fahrenheit. These two scales can be, if I give you a Kelvin scale and tell you to find the value of the Fahrenheit. So how to find that? We have a relation between these two scales, Celsius and Fahrenheit. That is, Celsius is equals to 5 by 9 F minus 32. You have to use this formula to find out one scale. If one scale is given, if I have given you Fahrenheit, you have to use this formula to find out the Celsius scale. Put the value of F minus it with 32 and multiply with 5 and 9, you will get the degree centigrade. Similarly, if you want to find Fahrenheit, then what you have to do, you have to write the value of degree Celsius, multiply it with the 9, divide it with the 5, and whatever answer you get, you subtract it, you add 32 to it, you will get the value of Fahrenheit. So this is the relation between the Fahrenheit and Celsius scale, that C is equals to 5 by 9 F minus 32. These are very important, these two scales, because these scales you will study in the grade 9 also. Now, measuring of temperature, how we measure the temperature? We measure the temperature through the thermometer. Yes, measuring of temperature, how we measure the temperature? We measure the temperature by using the thermometers. We have two different types of thermometers, clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. In your syllabus only we are going to study about the clinical and laboratory thermometer. Before going to the clinical and laboratory thermometer, we will see what are thermometers. You might have seen thermometer. So thermometer, I'm showing you, this is thermometer in my hand. Everyone knows that this is thermometer. It has a bulb. This is a mercury thermometer. We call it as mercury thermometer because it contains mercury inside it. Okay, this is a mercury thermometer. It contains a bulb. This is made up of glass and this bulb contains mercury. Okay, this mercury, you can see it is silver in color. And this is the bend at the bulb is called as kink. Okay, we use mercury. Why we use mercury in the thermometer? These are called mercury thermometers. Why we use mercury thermometers? What is the reason that why only mercury metal is used? The first thing is mercury is in the liquid state. It's present in the liquid state. Mercury remains in the liquid state and it melts at minus 38.87 degrees centigrade. Okay, mercury, it does not stick to the glass. Second point is, it does not stick to the glass. It expands and contracts immediately when it gains minimum amount of heat. And it is a good conductor of heat. It has the uniform expansion rate. So we use mercury in the thermometers. They have a uniform expansion. They expand very slowly. So we have two types of thermometers, clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Clinical thermometer that is used in the clinic. It's used by the doctor, so it is called as doctor thermometer also. And the laboratory thermometers are used in the labs. Laboratory thermometers are used in the labs as to do the experiments. So the thermometer that measures the body temperature is called as clinical thermometer. They are called as doctor thermometer also. So now I have shown you the clinical thermometer. I was having the clinical thermometer. Everyone has the clinical thermometer. So what precautions you have to take while reading the clinical thermometer? The thermometer should be washed with an antiseptic solution. We should always wash the thermometer with the antiseptic solution before you use. Either if you're not having any antiseptic solution, wash it with the cold water, no problem. Don't hold the thermometer from the bulb. Never touch the bulb of the thermometer. Okay, never touch the bulb of the thermometer. Next, you must ensure that mercury level of the thermometer should be below 35 degrees. Every time, whenever you go with the thermometer, you should see the mercury level should be below 35 degrees. Handle the thermometer very carefully. If it hits the solid objects, it easily breaks. Next, read the thermometer by keeping the level of the mercury along a sight. So you have to keep like this and then you have to read the value. So these are the precautions you should follow while using a thermometer. Next, laboratory thermometer. Can we use this thermometer in the labs? No, we cannot use. So we have a different type of thermometer called as laboratory thermometer. So clinical thermometer is used only for measuring the body temperature, but laboratory thermometer is used to measure the heat of the other objects. Okay, so it is a laboratory thermometer which measures the temperature of the other objects. It is also same like this, like clinical thermometer. It contains a thick walled fine bore glass capillary tube. It also contains a glass tube which we call it as capillary tube. This capillary tube has a small bulb which contains the mercury. The bulb and the small tube is filled with the mercury, and the temperature of the clinical thermometer is in between the range minus 10 degrees to 110 degrees. So the range is between minus 10 degrees to 110 degrees centigrade. So we must find the value between these two. So this was about the clinical and the laboratory thermometer. Okay, how can we measure the minimum and maximum day temperature? So we also have a minimum maximum thermometer. Okay, a thermometer called as minimum and maximum, or through which we can measure the temperature of the minimum temperature. What is the minimum temperature of the day and what is the maximum temperature of the day? Okay, it's in your book. So this is, you can see here. This is minimum and maximum temperature thermometer. Okay, it's always present. If you are having some people may have it at your home. This will show the minimum temperature and maximum temperature. The maximum temperature is calculated at the afternoon and the minimum temperature is calculated at the midnight when the temperature is very less. Okay. Now, till here, I'm going to end my topic till here. Thank you.